Hello, my name is Frank Toll. I'm the HNC and HND Contemporary Art Practice Lecturer of Inverness College UHI, and it is my pleasure to virtually open this exhibition of the HNC HND Contemporary Art students in collaboration with Lovestream. It has been a difficult few months for the students of Inverness College UHI due to COVID-19 and the government recommendations of lockdown. Art is a discipline that requires social interaction and collaboration. There's no doubt that our students have been finding things extremely difficult in these uncertain times. Despite the restrictions caused by lockdown, the contemporary art students of our college have shown determination and defiance in making new and exciting art pieces that are relevant to the current times. They have adapted and ultimately conquered these obstacles. The standard of work which will be shown here has been exceptionally high, which has made myself and the team extremely proud and honoured to have taught our students this academic year. And we, the lecturers, will have that pride for our students for 2020 to 2021. Thank you for Lovestream for hosting this event. The following film contains artwork submitted by some of the students from our HNC and HND Contemporary Art Practice Programme classes in aid of the Highland Food Bank, which can be found on www.blythswood.org. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to open this exhibition.
parallel reality.
And the numbers aren't coming down yet.
Parallel reality. In a parallel reality. In a parallel reality. In a parallel reality.
and I'm just terrified for her. I have a friend who's in an abusive relationship, and she's hid weapons all over her house. This is prior to this, when now she's now stuck in the home with her son and her partner.
So if you look at the house more of as a space within yourself, so the house isn't like a physical space as such. It's like more of a mental space. What if it's a protective space? Obviously, because you've storing things away that are traumatic.
It's like a part of your brain that gets damaged. When you have a stroke and part of your brain dies, it's like that part of the house has died.
She's woken up being choked and knowing that any day could be her last day. But I can't even call her because she's no idea whether her conversation's being recorded. She's no idea that he's listening outside the door. And he makes her show her phone records to ask why she's on phone calls with people for so long. So it's just, and I'm just terrified for her.
And then I was thinking about the graffiti on the wall. Somebody went in there and it's like, right, I'll just write on this wall, and they're like shitting on everything that's like really important in the house, and they're just like taking over. They like hurt them, but nobody can really see that they've hurt them. So you're putting your name there, but you're not letting people see all the hurt until somebody like really shines a light and they see that all that hurt you've been through.
You just don't know what triggers them. And I'm just terrified for her. Another time she's secretive and trying to get into a space in the house where he can't hear her.
I'm going into that space and writing my name. I'm trying to remember who I am. Not what everything else is trying to make me.
The same way as it's all charred and it's all burnt. But on the inside, we're still strong and we're still holding each other up. And we're still protecting each other. And we're still in touch with each other. And if we were to wash the charred off, we would look a little bit different. But we'd still be standing there with each other.
Hello, we hope you enjoyed our live stream exhibition. The HNC and HND CAP students would like to thank all of our lecturers for continued support during this difficult time. In particular, Frank Toe and Rachel Fermi for going above and beyond for each student. We honestly can't thank them enough. We would also like to give a big shout out to LoveStream and our very own Julie Williams for organising this event. All of the donations received tonight are in aid of the Highland Food Bank, so if you can, please donate.